The next stop is On the Radar Radio.
Stand clear of the closing doors, please.
Yeah.
Yes, sir, baby. On the Radar Radio, yo, special guest in the building, Quasi in the building. Welcome to the show, bro. How you feeling today?
Appreciate you. Amazing. Glad to be here.
This, where you coming from?
Brampton, Toronto.
Yeah. Brampton, Toronto. Yeah, yeah. I'm excited to have you, man. We actually Appreciate getting ready. We gonna be coming up to Toronto next year.
Amazing.
Yeah, we're gonna be doing a little OTR trip out there. But we glad that you came this way to come see. I kind of figured you were from Toronto without looking at your bio, because like when they first sent me your gram, I saw shout out my brother Bushman.
Oh yeah.
Like Bushman and Swagger were like the first two people I saw interacting with your shit, and I was like, all right, without even looking or listening to anything off the rip, I was like, oh yeah, he's from Toronto.
That's big love. Yeah, shout out Bushman, shout out Swagger. Like, it's all about showing up to the city. Yeah, appreciate it.
How long? So you've been in Toronto your whole life?
Yeah.
Your whole life?
Yeah.
So, because I know, so you're from, you have a musical background. Like, I've come from a very, very, very musical family.
Yeah.
Growing up, like, for you, what was it, first of all, where in Toronto are you from? You said Brampton?
I'm from Brampton, so I'm, like, 30 outside Toronto.
Okay, like, north, south?
West. Caught at the GTA, it's the greater Toronto area.
Got you. So, growing up out there, right, like, what was it like for you? Were you kind of forced heavily to pursue music as a kid? Coming from the family you come from?
Growing up, it was just one of the things that seemed natural because it was surrounding me all the time. Like, music was the soundtrack to everything that I did. Somebody was always playing music in the house. And then at some point, when I had taken an interest to it, that's when my parents were like, yeah, you got to take this shit seriously. My grandfather flew me out to Jamaica, went back to yard and started doing some production and stuff. And that's when it really started rolling. Like,
right.
Yeah.
Did you realize, like, how impactful your grandfather was in music coming up? Like, what, like, because I feel like when I talk to a lot of artists who come from these type of musical backgrounds, like, they don't realize until, like, they kind of get to, like, the middle school or high school age when they, like, oh, shit, wow, like, my family's actually, like, kind of important.
Yeah, no, my grandfather, Leroy Sibbles, he did the one-drop bass line for the Pass the Dutchie Rhythm. And growing up, this is a song you always hear, and I see, you know, niggas coming up to him, whatever, but it's, like, it's normal because I don't know any different. And then as I started, you know, growing up, making a name for myself, and niggas found out who I was. My grandfather actually used to live in the Dot in Toronto. So niggas were like, yo, we know about your grandfather. And that niggas like Don Dada type shit. So, like, yeah. It really is always deeper than rap. And, like, yeah, growing up with it, it helped me to sort of understand it. But now reflecting back on it, I have an appreciation for it that, you know, is a lot bigger than what it was before.
Right. And when it comes to, like, following, like, your own sound, because obviously the music you make is different, right?
100%.
Like, yeah. Did you feel ever, like, kind of, I want to say forced, but, like, when with your family and your grandfather, did he kind of, like, kind of push you to make something different or kind of follow in his footsteps? Like, what direction do you feel like you maybe were pushed to? And then kind of, like, where did you, like, decide that, okay, I want to go do this instead?
I was like maybe 10 or 11, but I guess I was on a little bad child run, and my parents shipped me out to Jamaica to go stay with him for a bit. And that nigga had me in the studio, like, locked in, like, creating. He got me a guitar, and I made this little two-chord song.
Right.
And he was like, that's it. This is it. This is what we've been waiting for. And he put me in the studio with a bunch of producers, and that was the first time I ever, like, saw the actual creative process of a song. So in a way, it was sort of, like, forceful, but just like how, you know, if your kid shows interest in something, you know what I'm saying? You want to help them build that, and you don't want them to really sway from it, like, you want to help them be productive with that skill and that talent, right?
Yeah, facts.
Yeah.
So that was
kind
of like the beginning of that.
That's where it really started, yeah. I've always been picking up instruments, playing shit by ear. Like, I've always really liked and appreciated and been a student of music. But that's when it really took off. That trip to Jamaica really solidified the career. Without that, I wouldn't be where I am.
How many instruments do you play?
Play? I could play the piano. I can, like, read piano. But I play piano. I used to play the saxophone. I play the drums. I play a little guitar. Like, not crazy, but I know how to get what I need to get to make the song.
Right. You know how to, like, buy your time. Or you know
exactly.
How to, like, kind of, like, do enough. You
right,
know what I'm saying?
Right,
you're not, like,
to build it up. Right.
You're not, like, a master, but you know what you need to do for your music.
Exactly. Yeah.
So, what's your music? Do you, like, because, you know, some people don't want to, like, just make beats, like, they want, like, that live instrumentation, right? Are you kind of like that too, where you care more for the live instrumentation in the actual songs,
or? Honestly, like, it's a mixture. You gotta move with it, how the vibe is. Like, my first track that ever caught some traction, I actually played the piano out on it, but I also used a sample. So it's like, you gotta tune into what you're saying, and then you have to construct art in all aspects.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It has to be, it has to be a vessel for what you're trying to convey.
Right.
So, it really depends. It depends on what I'm trying to capture. I don't really have a specific lane in terms of artistry. Like, art imitates life, so it's one of those things where, like, whatever I'm going through is what my music's gonna sound like. You know what I'm saying? So,
what you been going through lately?
Not too much. It's been pretty all right. I've been going through shit lately. I've been just trying to, you know, find different perspectives to highlight some of the crazy shit that's been happening. But really, it's just been like, it's been amazing to see all the love, and the motion is fucking insane. So we outside with it.
Right. You dropped the kid from your name, right?
Yeah.
How long has that been?
Started off as kid, so kid was like, for like maybe 3 years, and now it's been maybe a couple months since we dropped the kid. Okay. But it was always a plan, because like, I'm not.
Not a kid.
Not a kid, right? And beyond that, it's more impactful, you know.
Just Quasi.
Yeah.
Just Quasi is definitely more impactful.
Yeah.
Wait, the problem child came out a couple years ago, right?
Mm-hmm.
Back then, right? Because you said that like a lot of the stuff that you make music about is like reflective of like your life at the time.
And yeah.
Right now, you said now a lot's been going on, but back then, like, what was like with Problem Child? Like, where did you feel like the problem child back then? Like, what was going on that kind of made you influence that?
Problem Child is my take on. I was basically in this position, like, okay, because I make this music, all you bitches want to say that I'm toxic. You haven't really seen toxic. I could show you toxic. And so I just kind of detail out very explicitly that whole sort of tape from beginning to end. If you're listening to it in the way that I intended it to be perceived, I guess.
Right.
You're supposed to see a change in character.
Yeah.
I start off with the intro where I'm really talking some sweet shit and some real shit beyond the sweet shit.
Right.
And I finish off with embarrassing, which is basically like, you know. If you're embarrassed by me, the feelings are mutual. You know, don't get it twisted, right?
Mm-hmm.
And so just during that time, it was just a very fuck around and find out time for me. I wasn't really on the way I am right now, and I was going through so much. Everything always happens at the same time. You know, everybody will tell you they got a lot going on, but going through a lot, and I had to let some bitches know.
Right.
Pretty much, yeah.
Have you passed that period of your life? Do you feel like you've grown since then?
Yeah, it's one of them things where, like, if you if you give somebody that attention too much, it's like you're gonna convey that they're on the same level as you in a sort of way. Where, like, man, I've outgrown so many habits, people, like, vibrations that, like, I'm just on a different path, like, in terms of even what I'm saying. Like, all that stuff it comes from a place of ignorance, place of truth, but a place of ignorance. I'm on some enlightenment now. Yeah.
You're on some enlightenment
shit?
Yeah.
I'm trying to teach these niggas how the game go. Yeah.
And that's what this new music gonna sound like.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So that's more what you've been going, well, it's not really what you're going through, it's more what you want to teach people now.
It's what I learned. It's still.
Or show people what you learned.
It's still a little ignorant though, but it's saucy. It's saucy and it's a little bit more detailed. With it's not just fuck this bitch and whatever.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I'll explain to you why.
Right. Wait. You know, I kind of meant to begin the interview like the boys, like, you know, Bush and Swagger and there were a few other Toronto artists who I've seen, you know, you interact with. But like, what's the relationship there with those guys? Right.
Like, honestly, like.
Is this friendship through the music?
We haven't cooked. We haven't got in yet. But it's one of, at least the niggas in my city out in Brampton, like, always show love, always interacting very, very, like, as soon as I started getting on, like, Bush followed me before I really had anything going on, right? We never even met and extended a DM and all that shit. So, and then Swag, since I really started out, he's been showing love. So it's
cool.
Yeah, yeah. And shout out Roy too. Like, in terms of the city, in terms of the bees, like, yeah. it's really love, and I really appreciate that, because, you know, could be whatever, right?
Right. What other artists are from Brampton? Tory's from Brampton.
Tory's from Brampton, Roy's from Brampton, got Bush, Swag.
Oh, they're all from Brampton?
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah. Not Swag. Swag's not from Brampton.
I'm working on my, like, Toronto geography, you feel me? Like, I don't really know where everybody, you know, it's like when you come here, it's like you don't really know where everybody's from.
Right,
so
right.
I'm like learning, like, piece by piece when, like, each one of y'all come here. I'm
right.
Like, oh, okay, this person from this. Okay, so Tory, Roy.
And Bush. Yeah, okay, yeah, you. Off the top of the head. Jesse Reyes is also from Brampton, right?
Not a bad lineup.
Right. Alessia Carr, she might be from Saga, though. But yeah, no, the West Side, like, generally is staying connected right now. I love that shit. Right?
So what are we working on right now? Like, what do we have cooking? What's coming up?
We got a little project cooking, boiling up. Maybe some visuals. But really just phenomenal music. Like, Word. Art. Some of the shit that, like, dropping Problem Child, that's, like, my baby. I put that on my body. And, like, the struggle for me, at least, the plight of the artist is, like, fuck what everybody else thinks. If it's not good enough to me, it's not dropping.
Right.
And I've come to a place now where I'm fucking, I don't know, I'm fucking Shaq in the paint. Like, it's smooth. I found the fucking wave. So it's just, like, the music that is being created is... It's crazy. Yeah. I'm excited for it, at least.
Well, I'm excited for you.
I appreciate it.
Well,
thank
by the time
you,
the people see this freestyle now, so go check that out. So more music on my new project, more singles probably before the project.
Yeah.
Problem Child been out, so make sure you go run that up. Go
Please.
See that. Before we get up out of here, anything else you want to let the people know, where they can follow you at, all that good stuff, now's the time to do it. This camera right here.
Quasi Timberlake, KWAZII Timberlake at that's on Instagram. Yeah, I don't know. That's pretty much it.
Before we go, that's what I forgot to ask you. What's it, like, why Quasi Timberlake?
Okay. I'm a big Timberland fan in terms of production. And so when Justin Timberlake came out, when they had that little run, Timberlake and Timberland, like, the way they were merging their production with their beats, Timberlake just had a way of arranging his harmonies that can make a fucking song sound so full.
Facts, yeah.
And it's very specific what he chooses to lay down. So it's one of them things where, like, I'm Quasi Timberlake. Like, I'm the sauce with, you know, the actual structure and the understanding to put it all together.
I get it. I just had to ask that because I saw that. I was like, oh, interesting.
it's
Quasi Timberlake on Instagram. Make sure you go follow him. Go run up the freestyle. Go run up the Problem Child project out now. New music on the way.
I'm on the way.
Go follow him. Go show him some love. Go show him some support. Love is free. Support is free. But y'all already knew that. Till next time, Quasi on the radar. We out. Bow. My God. Love.
Appreciate you.